Hi Hackintosh friends, it's Teresa here from Morgonaut.cloud. Today I will show you how to build the perfect Hackintosh. I will show you the same method I personally use for every Hackintosh build I do. I will show you how to install macOS Mojave on your PC using so-called vanilla installation method. And I'll do it on my main production machine I use for all of my work. So after you watch this tutorial, even absolute beginner will be able to build the perfect macOS Mojave Hackintosh on its own. If you are new here, then make sure click that subscribe button. And remember, all the links mentioned in this video you can find in this video description below. Because I try to help beginners to start with Hackintosh build, so before we jump to the installation itself, I have to explain some basics, because this is where most of the new Hackintoshers do fatal mistakes. More experienced users can jump straight to any chapter. Timeline index is also in this video description. So, the most important in building a really stable and most compatible Hackintosh is to choose the right hardware. Again, listen carefully, to choose the right hardware. I will be discussing hardware in one of my next tutorials in detail. So now just briefly. Apple is a single company tweaking their macOS for just few hardware combinations they manufacturing. That's why they are so stable, snappy and have great performance. Their macOS is tied only to particular hardware. On the other side, in PC world, there is tons of manufacturers with tons of different models of motherboards, CPUs, GPUs, different quality, different chips, different revisions and so on. So, to build the perfect Hackintosh is not so easy, and you need to try match your components as close as possible to Apple ones. You can use free app called Mac Tracker to see what CPUs are in any Mac model, decide which chipset. So, the best way is always do research on internet before buying new components. Search for successful user builds, compatibility lists and so on, so you can avoid problems or to prevent totally unsuccessful tries. You can be very successful with your first build on first run, or you can also come into a lot of problems and headaches. It all depends on your hardware you choose. So I strongly recommend you to use verified and recommended hardware. In video description I share detailed list of components I used to shoot this tutorial. This build is verified, tested by me, so I can recommend it. It works like a charm, I use it every day. Now, desktops versus laptops. Well, desktops are more easier to hack than laptops, that's because they use more compatible or similar components like Apple have. Some configurations will surprise you how much compatible they are. In laptops, there are more likely some components that simply will not work, like Wi-Fi or Bluetooth chips. You can also have problems with trackpads. So for a beginner, I would not recommend to start with a laptop. Now, let's talk about what is the so-called vanilla installation method and why I recommend to use that. Vanilla installation is the most clean way how to install a Hackintosh. That means that after basic Hackintosh installation is completed, the system itself is identical to every other system on a real Mac. There are no changes in it to make it to work with just the PC hardware. Vanilla install's main partition is identical to that of an official Apple computer. All the Hackintosh magic is done only on a small hidden partition called EFI. That means that when you, for example, take out the Hackintosh disk and connect it to a real Mac, it will run as expected without any complaints. That also means that vanilla Hackintosh is more proof of future update failures or breakdowns. It uses only Apple's native files and is also more stable and booting faster. So, in other words, by the software side, it's identical and intact to the real Mac ones. But to build a Hackintosh using the vanilla way, it needs a little bit of more work and knowledge than other installation methods like Olarela, which I made a tutorial about 3 weeks ago. So, now let's stop talking and start building a perfect Hackintosh. First, we need to download the original Apple installer from the App Store. If you don't have access to macOS computer, you will need to use other installation method like Olarela. Link to my step-by-step video tutorial is now on top right corner. First, we need to download the Apple's official macOS Mojave installer. Open your App Store app. You will have it probably in featured section, but you can also search for it. Simply click on download button and wait. Depending on your Ethernet connection speed, it can take 5 to 15 minutes. I fast-forwarded so it will download in a second. When it's downloaded, install macOS Mojave application will pop up. We don't want to install it now, we need to create an USB installer first, so close this app and the App Store too. Now connect 8GB plus USB disk and hit initialize, or open disk utility manually by hitting Command and Space and write in disk utility. On the top left, click on the triangle and select Show all devices. In the left column, locate your USB disk name and click on Erase. Again, be sure it is really the correct disk. Here you can name your disk. I recommend call it installer. In Scheme, choose GUID partition map. And format, leave macOS extended journaled and confirm it by clicking on Erase button. Now quit disk utility. In Finder hit Command Shift plus A, it will bring the Applications folder, and make sure the Install macOS Mojave is there. Scroll down to Utilities folder and open Terminal application. Paste in this command, which is in video description. You can see at the end there is Installer. It is the name of our USB disk. If you called it differently, then here write the same name. Hit enter, write your password, hit enter again. Now type Y, like yes, I want really to continue. This can take a really long time, in my case it took about 30 minutes, so again I fast forwarded, so you don't need to wait.
But at this point only real Macs can boot from it. But we, Hackintosh users, need to do one more step. Install a bootloader so your PC can boot from it.
In web browser, navigate to this page and click on download. Wait 5 seconds to start. Here just double click it to unzip it. We can close Safari. And now we will install the bootloader to our USB installer disk. Right click on the Clever package and click open. Continue. And here be careful, we want to install the bootloader onto our USB disk, but at default the installer wants to install on my internal system disk. So click on the bottom on Change Install Location and choose the Install macOS Mojave USB disk. Click on Customize. Most of you will have UEFI capable motherboard, so check the first two options and in UEFI drivers uncheck first three and check only VBOX HFS, APFS driver loader and Apteo memory fix. In future when Nvidia will release driver for Mojave, you may need also the EMU variable UEFI. AMD GPUs don't need it. Last check you are installing it on the correct disk and click on Install. Write your password and wait till finished. Complete. For easier configuration, download Clever Configurator app from this page. Again, double click to unzip it. And open the Clever Configurator now. If you get safety error, then choose right click and open. On your desktop you will have EFI disk, navigate to EFI, Clever, right click on config.plist and open it with Clever Configurator. Down left click on Kext Installer, top right select Other option. It will install kernel extensions to this other folder on your EFI disk partition. That's exactly what we want. Now select Lilu, whatever green, and on the bottom the fake SMC. And click on download. As you can see in Finder window, it is downloading. Now check all sensors and click install. These are sensors to monitor CPU temperature, voltages and so on. Now we can quit Clever Configurator. Delete the config.plist and empty the trash. We will create our own configuration. Go to this website, which is a very good resource for vanilla users. On the left, choose the correct architecture of your CPU. So if you have, for example, i7-8700K like me, then choose Coffee Lake. Scroll down to absolute bottom and click on sampleconfig.plist here. Again, scroll to bottom, click anywhere in raw paste data section, command A to select all, command C to copy it. Close Safari and open text edit. Now in format menu, choose make plain text or shift command T. And paste our copied text to it. Command S to save it and save it to your desktop as config.plist. And now just open for the last time the EFI partition and copy the config.plist on your desktop into EFI Clever folder. Right click and open in Clever Configurator. In SMBIOS section, you can change to Real Mac model, which is closest to your configuration, or leave it as is. More info about SMBIOS settings you can find in my video tutorial about fixing iMessage. Link is now at top right corner. In boot section, you can see verbose boot flag. That means that during installation, it will display all debug informations, so we can analyze it in case something went wrong. And that's it, macOS Mojave USB Vanilla Installer is finished. Now reboot your PC and set your BIOS to these recommended settings. Boot from our USB installer and be sure it wants to boot from Install macOS Mojave. It will start to display dozens of debug messages, just sit and wait. Choose your language, I'll choose English so everybody can understand it. Click on Disk Utility and continue. Top left triangle and select Show all devices as we did earlier. Now select the name of the disk you want to install Mojave to. Click on Erase, name your disk for example Mojave. You can leave macOS Extended Journal, installer will convert it to APFS anyway. In Scheme should be always GUID and click on Erase. Close Disk Utility and select Install macOS and click on bottom Continue. Continue again, agree twice and select the name of your disk on which you want to install and click on Install. The installation will reboot itself two times, so don't worry. Take a coffee, beer, smoke some good things and relax. Here be sure the bootloader wants to boot from our disk Mojave and not the USB installer. And again, we want to boot from our Mojave disk and not from the USB installer. You can change it by keyboard arrows. Here just briefly fill in all informations. I covered it in detail in my other video. Link is now at the top right corner. But I think you already know very good what to fill in here. Now, to be able to boot from your disk without the USB installer disk, we need to install a bootloader, so copy hack utils we created earlier to your desktop. Double-click to unzip a Clever installer. When you get this message when trying to open it, just right-click on it and select Open. This will bypass the system check. Here again, be careful. We want to install the bootloader this time on our Mojave disk. Click on Customize and again set the same options as we did when creating USB installer. And click on Install. Write your password you created at the end of installation. The EFI disk on your desktop is the hidden EFI partition on our Mojave disk. Now unzip the Clever Configurator, right-click and open. On the left, click on Mount EFI, find your USB installer and click on Mount Partition. So this white disk is the hidden EFI partition on the USB installer disk. Open it.
Open also the Mojave Disk EFI side by side. Delete the EFI folder on Mojave Disk completely and empty the trash. Now just drag the EFI from USB to Mojave Disk while holding Alt key. In video I accidentally moved them, you copied them. Now your system is able to boot without USB installer disk, just using your hard disk or SSD. So reboot your PC and disconnect the USB disk. Select your Mojave disk as a boot disk. Make sure you are booting from Mojave disk. Use arrow keys to change it.
Congratulations! Now let's check if our hardware is correctly recognized.
My internal iGPU Intel HD 630 is recognized, as well as my RX Vega Frontier Edition. But as you can see, my Ethernet is not working. So how to fix it? This step you should have done already before the installation itself, but I wanted to show you what to do when you face the same problem with something is not working like my Ethernet.
We need to identify what exact hardware components we have in our build.
I have Z370 Aorus Gaming 5 motherboard, so I'll simply Google it. And here in specifications, I'll try to find what my Ethernet chip is. Bang! My chip is Intel made. Now I just need to download correct kernel extensions for it. Great resource for it is this webpage. Here you can find bunch of kernel extensions for desktops and laptops. I'm searching for Intel Ethernet, it's here. Click on Downloads and download the latest one. Now I just copy it to my USB installer to move it to my Mojave machine. Now go back to your Mojave computer and boot it. I copied the hackutils from USB to my desktop again. Open Clever Configurator. Mount EFI and mount EFI of your Mojave disk. Navigate to Clever Kexts Other. Unzip the Rehabman Intel driver or any other driver for your component and simply copy it to the other folder. And that's all. Now after reboot, my Ethernet should work. So reboot your Hackintosh. I reboot it and let's look to about this Mac, system report, Ethernet. Bang, my Ethernet is working.
I must mention that most of the desktop components currently on the market have their compatible kernel extensions, but still some of you may already have some incompatible components, so you will then have no chance to get it working under macOS. So that's why I told you in the introduction of this video how important is the choosing right hardware before buying your components and starting the installation. So the most important as a first step is to do a research. Google for motherboard you plan to buy and search for any successful Hackintosh build. Once you find compatible hardware, then go on, buy it and do a vanilla installation using this tutorial. You may then still be facing other problems like iMessage or sound not working and so on, so make sure you click the subscribe button and bell next to it and follow my tutorials how to fix these issues. I would be glad when you post in the comments your successful build info and share your experience so other users can benefit from it too. I hope you'll post them already from your new perfect Hackintosh macOS Mojave build. Enjoy it! I would enjoy when you can support me on my Patreon page so I can do more tutorials for you. There you can also always reach my personal help via Facebook, Reddit, Messenger or Skype, and I also offer a remote session help so I can connect directly to your computer and help you. I hope you found my today's tutorial useful. If so, click on the like button below. Thank you for watching and see you next time.